That's one of the reasons why we're so proud to be building net zero homes here in Canada. We're looking at being able to reduce not just operational carbon footprint, but also the embodied carbon, starting to look now at what we put into our homes and how we can reduce the overall total carbon footprint of our homes. Customers are also very concerned about indoor air quality, so it's important that we can give them fresh air all the time. When looking at designing a net zero home or high performance home, it's important to take a whole home holistic approach to how we're going about the design. You can't add mechanical systems in at the very end and have success with it. You've really got to start looking at it up front as part of your overall design process. That's why I love the Master Decision Guide that we've been using. One really important point is to look at balancing the loads, which is why picking windows that are low solar glass become critically important, because we want to balance the heating and cooling loads. By getting that taken care of early, we're actually able to reduce bulkheads, reduce the amount of materials that are being used, and create a greater level of comfort for our clients.
As the decision guide would suggest, we use a medium velocity, low leakage duct system. We also use high supplies on our walls. We use modulating furnace and a modulating cooling equipment, and also recommending that our clients use the low fan speed continuous for constant air circulation in the home. Using these options produces a high performance design that improves the operational efficiency while reducing our carbon emissions and, of course, keeping the home comfortable. Heating and cooling in the home are provided by a gas modulating furnace and an air source heat pump. The selection of high wall supply outlets is one of the design options that will help increase occupant comfort. When you have your air coming from the top of the room and mixing from across the ceiling, you decrease the amount of drafts that your client is feeling. There are other design elements that you can incorporate in order to increase your occupant's comfort. One of these would be making sure that you have tight ductwork that isn't leaking, and also making sure that ductwork is sized properly to the loads in the home. We also take into consideration the solar heat gain coefficient on our windows. This can really help in rooms that are going to have that higher heat load. Modulating equipment really helps with the comfort in your home. This is because it's able to reduce its output and increase its run times while still having the capacity to operate on the coldest days and not have to operate at that same capacity every day of the year. As a mechanical designer, I really appreciated the way the mechanical decision guide was laid out. I would recommend it to any mechanical designer who would like to use it to facilitate conversations with builders they're working with or clients to really address the whole home approach and overall produce a better mechanical design.
Our overall impression of using the Master Planning and Decision Guide is it gives us a good guideline in order to go back and reference, are we getting our designs right? Are we picking the right locations for our mechanicals? Are we pulling the right type of systems in place so that we're creating the greater occupant comfort, better indoor air quality, all of those decisions that we want to try and reinforce with our customers.